Morning, folks. Brian King here. I wanted to share a little mindset lesson with you, that I was reminded of this morning. I had to get up early to go for a blood draw. Yes, I know how to party. And on the way back at a stoplight, I looked to my left and there was a truck for a septic tank company. And my mind, like any other person's mind, went immediately to my associations of what it means to have a septic tank. And of course, my first response was, ew. And I started picturing a septic tank and started thinking about what's in a septic tank. And my brain started talking about how icky and ooey that was. And then I stopped myself when I caught that train going through my mind and thought to myself, really? Why, when I have the option of the other direction, which I'll get to in a second, why am I choosing this line of thought? Why am I choosing to go icky, ooh, nasty, smelly, stinky, get it away from me? Because think about it. When you assess things in that way, what does it do for your mind? What does it do to your physiology, your body? You tense up, you think negatively, you're thinking in a repelling way. Now, mind you, that kind of thinking has its place. You know, when you're thinking about lunch options, you don't want to romanticize a dumpster, you know? So it makes sense that your mind would repel certain things. Certain things you don't want to eat. You want to have the ooh, icky, keep it away from me, okay? But in general, there are things that we go through life assessing negatively just because. You know, there was no danger presented to me in a septic tank truck where I needed that ooh, icky, get away from me. But there was that story that created that tension, that negativity, that ooh. And when you think about how many times a day you do that, and then at the end of the day, when you look back at your day and think about the quality of it, the things that you took the time to notice, to place value on, tend to be the things that you remember. So if you have a lousy day, chances are you did a lot of assessing of the things that didn't work, that you didn't like, that stunk, and some of those things you need to change because they have an impact on the quality of your life. But there were a lot of things that you chose to judge that have nothing to do with the quality of your life. You just happen to have an opinion about it. So you spent some time on that opinion, thinking how icky and inferior or whatever labels you put on it, you spent the time creating that experience in yourself, ramping up the negativity, and that stuff can stay with you throughout the day and accumulate, and before you know it, you feel like you had a lousy day. And a high percentage of that is because of what you chose to focus on. So let me tell you what I did with the truck to turn things around. I looked at the septic tank truck and I did the ooh, icky, like I said. And when I caught myself, I said, no, wait a minute. I need to spin this because I want to live in happiness and gratitude as much as possible. So how do I flip this? So I go from ooh, icky, negativity, judgment to gratitude. Well, I looked at it and I thought, well, this guy provides a wonderful service for people that have septic tanks, who for whatever reason don't have typical city plumbing and they can't get rid of that stuff as easily or readily. So they need a specialist who can come into their life and give them exactly what they need in a professional manner. You know, I talked up the value of the service this person provides and I imagined people being helped. Instead of focusing on the ooh icky of it, which is, you know, just details, I focused more on the experience of the people being served. And I know that I like it when I'm taken care of. And I like it when people I care about are being taken care of. So I imagined this person going to a house and being greeted with a smile, the person saying, thank you, I'm so glad you're here, this is broken, needs to be fixed. And I focused on that experience. So instead of creating tension in my body, I felt the tension leave my body. Now imagine if you spent your day picking out those experiences or putting your mindset on those experiences, turning it into something useful, something positive. How do you think you're going to feel at the end of the day then? You may come home a lot more relaxed, calmer. Not to say you will have a day that's completely agitation-free. It's nice when those days happen. But just to accumulate those memories or those experiences of gratitude, of being hopeful, of being grateful, look for those opportunities. And in a situation that looks inherently negative, the most fun you can have during the day, or some of the most fun you can have, is turning that around, finding the positive. It's a wonderful little exercise. And sometimes your mind needs to stretch, but it's absolutely worth it. So that's my two cents on this from a little morning experience. I hope it's helpful. Please leave me some comments. Let me know if this resonates with you. And feel free to share it with other people if you want to. Until next time, this has been Brian. Thanks for being you.